Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy Kenny, and this is Too Close to Home Season 2, Episode 4, and the name of this episode is A Happy Invasion. Now, the episode picked up where we actually saw all the news crew all coming into Happy Alabama, you know, trying to find Anna. And the episode opens up, it's at the diner, because we actually saw that Octavia and Bonnie actually saw the trucks, you know, going down the street. Well, Sheriff Mobley arrives to talk to Bonnie, you know, in regards to the press being there and all that. And then Octavia being all nosy, talking about something, oh, yeah, because the Secret Service, you know, have you found out what's going on? Who's behind it? I'm like, Octavia is a busybody like shit. She is one nosy. She is nosy and messy as hell. So, yeah, you got to watch fucking, you know, Octavia. She is always, you know, she was always sneaking shit when she was growing up. Because she just real sneaky of how she does things. So, pretty much, Jeff Moby's like, you know, Bonnie, let's go over here and talk, you know, nosy ass. So they start talking. Pretty much he lets her know that, yeah, you probably need to, like, get in touch with Anna, you know, that this is going on. And next thing you know, while they're talking in regards to that, and he also brings up Mama Jolene's trailer. He's saying that that trailer has many health code violations. You need to clean that place up, you know, and you know, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Y'all got to get that place cleaned up. But Bonnie said that, look, she won't let me do anything. She won't let me clean nothing. She won't let me move anything. She wants to keep everything the way it is, you know. And then, like, Jeremy was like, well, what the hell you mean? You know, she don't want you to do nothing. Shit, she can't move. Hell, her ass can't even get out of bed. But I'm like, man. But he was just adamant, like, look, you guys need to get that taken care of. But then Bonnie had another to be getting mad and shit. I'm like, bitch, you know that damn trailer's disgusting? You just got to the point where you got comfortable with that bullshit. And he's saying that no more. Clean this shit up. She's saying that shit, your mother could die in the fire with all them damn plugs and shit all in one socket, you know. And then, like, you know, she got trash and everything all over the place. And then the place smells. Like, come on. Ain't nobody trying to be around that bullshit. So I understand where Cheryl Mobley was coming from. But then while they're having this conversation, Nelson and Brody come in. And, of course, Bonnie's happy to see Brody. And he even surprises Octavia. So now Octavia knows he's back. But then... Hold on to the fact when I said Octavia sneaky, because I'm definitely going to bring this shit up. Because I definitely peeped this. But next thing you know, Brody's trying to talk to Bonnie. Bonnie is still giving him the cold damn shoulder. Man, they get in the back and they have this damn screaming match because Brody is like, why the hell are you being so cold to me? What the fuck is going on? It's like all of a sudden now you don't want to talk to me. You kind of like get tensed up every time I'm around you. What the fuck is going on? And it's like, do I need to remind you that you were straddling onto me just a while back? And then all of a sudden now this is how you're treating me? Like, what the fuck is going on? And it's like, Brody can't win because Brody just has women issues left and right. He having issues with Anna and having issues with Bonnie. And you dating two sisters. Well, because actually technically he's not dating Anna, but he does still care for her. And he probably does still have feelings for her. But him and Anna's situation is kind of far gone. And it's like, Bonnie, he's trying to talk to you. He wants you to open up to him, and you won't say shit. So she just flips. She's like, look, I don't want to talk to you. I don't care to talk to you. Just leave me alone. Just leave me be. Stop talking to me. Stop bothering me. If it ain't work-related, you know, because we know that Dr. Allen actually owns the diner. And he said, look, if you don't have nothing to say to me that's work-related, just leave me the hell alone. Just leave me alone. And I'm like, Bonnie, you forever making this shit difficult. You know you love a man. Just admit the shit. It's obvious you love him because you wouldn't be acting like that if you didn't. See, that's the thing. It's like actions speak louder than words because her actions is showing that she's in love with him. And she just can't grapple with the fact that he still has feelings for Bonnie or some unresolved issues with Anna. So we actually saw that go down. Yes. So, back at the damn... Oh, yeah, and also, when Octavia takes her, you know, pretty much takes her break, and she's going to take Mama Jolene's food to her, because we remember from last episode, she wants to pluck Mama Jolene's brain to see if she has been seeing any whereabouts of Regina sneaking out at night and shit. Has she seen anything? Because Mama Jolene be having a mirror and she sees everything. She another nosy one. So it's like, here we got two nosy ass people about to meet. And man, must I say, that scene was funny as I don't know what. Because Mama Jolene was just cruddy as fuck to her. But Octavia was cruddy too, because she pretty much stood at the fucking window, and she wasn't going to go no further than that window. She's like, come on in here. Just come on in. And she's like, oh, no. I'm fine where I am, thank you. I'm like, I don't blame you, Octavia. I'm going to go in that damn house either, shit. And then she's like, oh, you really think you special, don't you? And she's like, look, the reason why I'm here is because I wanted to bring you your food, and I wanted to ask you questions about my sister-in-law. She's like, who the hell is that? She's like, you know, she's kind of like my height, but she has like braids and stuff. Like, well, I don't know. I don't know who the hell she is. Like, I've never seen her before. I don't know what you're talking about. But she said that I need you to kind of keep a lookout for me to see if you've seen her walking around or anything like that, or is she going somewhere. Like, I need to know what's going on. And they pretty much make a deal where she asks, where she pretty much, well, because, like, it gets to the point where, you know, she pretty much, Octavia is so desperate to find out, and this is just to show you how nosy Octavia is. But then again, I understand the suspicion, because this is your big brother, so you got to do what you got to do. This situation, I was with her. But any other time, like, Octavia just, she just a real nosy ass. And you just gotta really pay attention to that shit. Because she gets you out of hand with that. But, she pretty much tells her, I'll pay you $10, you know, if you keep track on her and let me know if you see anything out of the ordinary. She's like, nah, give me $20. She's like, I'm not gonna give you no $20. She shut that damn window on her ass so quick. She's like, okay, $15. She's like, okay. And also, I need you to help me to find Shelby. She's like, I don't know where the hell to find Shelby. You know, what the hell? But she's like, well, we already got this taken care of. We know where we stand. Okay, thank you. And shut the damn window on her face. I'm like, Mama Jolene, you mean bitch. Like, damn. But the funny thing about it is that while that's going on, we see that trifling motherfucker M and Regina are fucking in his van. And I'm like, y'all motherfuckers are trifling as hell. First of all, your husband's back in town and you don't even know it. And your wife could pop back, you know, could just pop back home any damn time. And he just getting it in with her ass. You know, then all of a sudden, they saw Octavia coming. So, pretty much they tried to fake like he tried to fake like he was fixing his car or whatever. But she goes and approaches him. She obviously notices that, one, his pants is unzipped, and he ain't got no damn shoes on. So she's already kind of, and I'm saying this is just to show you how nosy Octavia is, because Octavia literally is peeping right now that shit is kind of off. She can't put a finger on it, but soon she sees something, she is like a mouse going for a piece of cheese. She's going to keep going until she gets that cheese. And that's exactly what she's doing. And he's just kind of playing it off like, well, I haven't seen, because she's asking, have you seen Regina, you know, going around here in any, you know, hours of the night or whatever. She's like, oh, no, I haven't seen her at all. You know, I haven't seen her, you know, but if I see her, I'll let you know. And then he's like, you looking good today, I tell you. And she's like, are you flirting with me? Stop. I'm like, I tell you, get your ass home, crazy ass. But, I mean, I do like Octavia, but Octavia is nosy as shit. But then again, I understand why, because this is your big brother. And, nah, you ain't gonna let no bitch just come in and just break his heart like that. But little do you know, you just talk to the motherfucker who's involved. Next thing you know, afterwards, he go back up in the damn truck. She's like, she's panicking and paranoid, like, oh my God, you know, I need to go, I need to go. And he's like, no, baby, stay. I got this. I got this. We're good. Don't worry about it. She doesn't suspect anything. We're fine. And then they go back to fucking again. And I'm like, see, y'all motherfuckers, I can't wait for their asses to get caught. Because they both get on my fucking nerves. Both of their asses ain't got no jobs, ain't got nothing going for themselves. And why the hell this nigga getting disability? Can somebody ask me that? Can somebody answer that question for me? Why is this fool getting disability? Because obviously, you know, he had no problem, you know, he ain't got no problem getting his dick wet every now and then. Or pretty much every night, you know, hour by the hour, minute by the minute, him and Regina sneaking off doing something. So, where's the disability? How are you disabled? Please answer me that. But then again, I think he was also in the military at one point too. But ain't nothing wrong with him. The only thing that's wrong with him is that he's selfish. And he's obviously full of himself. But, you know, because while they was having that conversation, Octavia did bring up about, you know, her husband being in Japan. But she didn't actually say that he was back. So she's already got suspicions, but she's not telling everything. Because she asks, is he back? And she's like, oh, no. I'm like, but he is, bitch. You just saw him at your job. Lying. Lies. Like, girl. But then again, it's like, okay, I think she's probably on to something, you know, that something ain't right with, you know, with Elm, but she can't put her finger on it. Okay, next I'm going to talk about is Victor and Valerie. We actually see that Victor and Valerie are at the house. She's got Brody's laptop, and she actually, you know, pulls up his contacts because he's saying that, you know, I need to do something to help my mother and everything, so I need to get my contacts. And we actually find out that the person he ends up calling is an actual senator that he was cheating on Dax with. And also, while they're having this conversation, you know, Valerie is completely clueless to who Dax really is. She's saying that, look, we're just like, you know, interns in the White House. I mean, Dax don't have that kind of power. He ain't got no kind of pull to get your, to send your people home. But he's like, look, you really, sorry about that. Victor pretty much told Valerie, look, you really don't know him as well as you think you do. So, because, yeah, at that moment, he saw how powerful Dax was. Because Dax did that shit and didn't blink of deporting his family. So what he ends up doing is that finally he gets his contacts, you know, because his phone was broken. She got his contacts. He borrows her phone and actually calls the senator for help, that he needs help, you know, with his family or whatever. And next thing you know, we actually see Dax is at the hotel, and him and Caitlin, a.k.a. First Lady, is on the phone talking. And pretty much she's saying that he's ready to leave. He's ready to get the hell up out of here. And she's like, oh, no, I need you to stay. And he's like, what the fuck you mean you need me to stay? He's like, no, I need you to stay. You know, I come to find out that damn Thomas been fucking calling her ass. So now I'm going to send the damn news crew down there and I'm going to fuck with her some more because I'm sick of his bull. I'm going to let him know he ain't going to be playing no damn games with me and shit. So Dex is just pissed off because he's like, man, I'm ready to get the fuck up out of here. What the hell is this shit? And she's like, well, what the hell? Like, shit, you didn't have a problem when you was running down there trying to help your fucking man just to find out that your man was cheating on your ass. Like, what the fuck? You know, all of a sudden now you ready to leave? She's saying that, look, if you stay, I'll make it worth your while. You know, and she's saying that, look, you're the only person that can get close to Anna, so I need you there as someone that can get close to her. You know, because we definitely know that the Secret Service, the guy, Yuri, he's down there trolling Anna, and we actually see in the episode that he does find her again, and they have this back and forth, but he pretty much lets her know that, look, it is not wise for you not to respond to him because he is manic. He's fucking crazy. I'm trying to, because he actually began to talk to her as a human being. At first, you know, Yuri's a fucking robot. He's going to do whatever the fucking president says. And he's not going to argue against it. But at that moment, he started to develop his humanity because, he, in a way, he kind of feels sorry for Anna, but ain't shit he can do, you know, to stop him. And he pretty much said that, look, your best bet is to just play this thing till he loses interest, because you walking away from him, he is not going to give up, and he will get more vindictive, he will get more dangerous, and it will get more crazy. So he's trying to warn her, but, you know, she's pretty much saying that, you know, you and him can go straight to hell. Then Brody comes and scoops her ass up and says, get your ass in the truck, and they pull off. Oh, yeah, but then also, going back to Dax and the First Lady, you know, they're having this conversation, and he pretty much kind of throws shade, like, shit's like, wow, the funny thing about it, you doing this just because your husband's cheating on you from a country girl from, you know, from Happy Alabama. And she threw shade back and was like, and your boyfriend cheated on you and you deported his parents. Got anything else to say, bitch? I was like, okay, Caitlin, I see you. She was quick with that damn comeback. Set that ass up. Now we also see that Thomas, the president, is about to, do his address. He's about to address the public since he's, you know, come out of the hospital. And we definitely see that they both are just sharpening their claws, you know, going after each other. And it's crazy, because now all the press is down in Happy Alabama trying to pretty much get a story on Anna. Oh, yeah, and also real quick, there was also a scene between Frankie and the sheriff. The sheriff is a damn smooth operator because he was trying to flirt, you know, talking about how pretty her eyes are. But the reason why he got in touch with her is because he was saying that Frankie used to be a therapist, and he thinks that Mama Jolene suffers from being a hoarder and that she needs, you know, therapy. And that Frankie would be the best person to actually help her with that. But she used to be a therapist. She's no longer licensed, but Sheriff was like, look, you know, could you please do this? And she agrees to, but then he's kind of flirting with her. But then yet, there's still more mystery about Frankie that we don't know yet. And I think in time, that will come out, like, who Frankie really is. But yeah, there's still some suspicion there in regards to her. Oh yeah, got that. All right, so we actually also have a scene with Brody and Anna. They talk about Rebel, and they also talk about her father. Brody had no fucking idea that her father was arrested, was pretty much in jail for 5 years for pedophilia. He thinks that he was in jail for 5 years for a fight at the bar. But then when she actually tells him that he is Rebel's father, he now realizes that the father was raping all three of them, and, you know, Rebel is his daughter. But now he's lusting for her. And pretty much you know, my boy Brody ready to bury this nigga. He's like, shit, let's fucking get rid of this guy. He's got to go. And Anna's like, no, don't do it like this. Let's call Sheriff Mobley. He's like, man, fuck Sheriff Mobley. What the fuck Sheriff Mobley gonna do? Matter of fact, what does Sheriff Mobley do anyway? And I was like, damn, Brody. And then we see him call Sheriff Mobley, and he's like, Sheriff Mobley, get your ass over here. He's like, oh, yeah, I'll be over there soon. Okay, bye-bye. And I'm like, then they get over there, and pretty much they have a conversation, and pretty much Brody is, like, adamant that he wants to kill that son of a bitch. Like, I want this guy to disappear. And if you don't do something, I'm going to make him disappear. And Sheriff lets him know, like, you know, are you talking about, you know, committing an offense? You know, pretty much committing a crime? Like, come on now. And you're going to do this right in front of me? I'm like, man, everybody does this shit right in front of you, Sheriff Brody, Sheriff Mobley, because don't nobody give a damn about you being a sheriff for real. You kind of like, you know, it's kind of like everybody knows you. So everybody's like, oh, that's your Sheriff Mobley. What the fuck? You know. And pretty much he's saying that, look, this guy, you know, Anna's father, has a very powerful family. And that's, I think, how he got out of jail. So he's pretty much saying that, look, you're pretty much looking for a needle in the haystack, and things could get crazy. So we need to kind of pursue this the legal way and not try to do anything else. But, yeah, Brody ready to put the, you know, Freddie ready to put the, I'm sorry, Brody ready to put the father 6 feet under. And I'm with him on that shit. Next, we actually see that down at the Honky Tonk Bar, oh, yeah, when the press came into the diner in the beginning of the episode, Sheriff Mobley sent their asses on a wild goose chase. So a lot of them are now at the Honky Tonk Bar getting drinks and shit. Damn, Shelby and Rick are there. They pretty much decide they're going to scam motherfuckers and shit, get people to open their tabs where they can kind of like, you know, they can pretty much rob them and shit. So he pretty much pursues these ladies or whatever and kind of coaxes them to say that, you know, I can give you information about Anna if you dance with me. So he's pretty much got her. And then we actually see damn Shelby's crazy motherfucking ass. Oh, yeah, and JD's ass showed up. Oh, yeah. Did you actually peep how JB and Rick looked at each other? See, I'm starting to think the reason why JB's homophobic is because, you know, JB's on the DL. And he doesn't want nobody to know how he, you know, likes to get it on the late night. So that's pretty much what's going on with that motherfucker. That's why I think why he's so adamant about going after gays. Because he's trying to hide his own gayness. And besides, we know this fool's a drug addict, so he's probably, you know, licked and got stabbed by a few of them, you know, just to get that hit. Let's just be real. But, we actually see that Shelby sits down with, old boy that we met in season one named John, who's a reporter with the, I think the Herald Sun, I believe. And he tried to ambush Anna up in D.C. Now his ass is down in Happy Alabama, and him, I mean, pretty much, you know, Shelby's kind of flirting with him, and then she lets him know that she's Anna's sister. So he's like, shoot, I can tell you everything you want to know. So I'm like, oh, fuck. Shelby gonna call some more shit. You done already got shot by your damn mama. Now you're going to create some more, you know, crazy shit for Anna. Like, bitch, did you ever stop? I mean, I swear, it's like, Shelby's like the damn Tasmanian devil. Everywhere she goes, she creates chaos. Crazy ass. Next, we actually see JB getting all these dudes riled up, you know. We're going to go in that damn house, and we're going to finish the job of killing that queer, and we're going to kill that other one. We got to send a message to these queers here in this town. I'm like, oh, what? Oh, what's the message? What's the message, JB? That you like it rough? Or do you like it nice and easy? Is that the message you're trying to send? But you just don't want them to tell it. You want to continue to keep that message behind closed doors. You know, just like how you was trying to, you know, get it in with Dex, and now because Dex beat your ass, now you want to kill everybody because he know your chief. That's what it is. You want to kill these motherfuckers because, and you definitely want to kill Dex because Dex know your tea, and you're afraid that he's going to go around town spilling tea and letting everybody know how you was trying to come on to him and how you was, you know, getting your rocks off, you know, coming off to him, you know, with this sexual aggressiveness that you was doing. So we actually see that, yeah, JB is now trying to lead a movement to kill the gays, you know, so he can continue to stay in the closet and be ashamed of his own gayness. So I'm pretty much said that, but if I missed anything, leave it down in the comments. I'll be more than happy to address it. But that's my review for Too Close to Home. Subscribe to my channel. Leave comments. Share this video. Like this video. And I will be back with you guys next week for another episode of Too Close to Home. So until then, everybody, take care.